Hello everyone, it's Monika here and welcome to my channel. Today I'm coming to you with a new collection by Crafters Companion. This one is called Easter Joy. So we've got some, I will show you those samples I've created with this collection later on. But first let me show you the products. So we've got five sets in this collection. So we've got the Joy. It's a Joy at Easter, that's how it's called. It's an acrylic stamp set and it has this word Joy, Easter, and there are two sets of leaves and this dove. Looks really pretty and I used it quite a few times. So this is a very cute set, and what you can do, you can, because the Joy it's joined together, but you can stamp and cut them out and you can line them up in different ways. So it's really fun stamp set to use. So that's the first one. Then we've got this beautiful springtime scene. It's a set of cutting dies. It's really cute, and as you can see on those two, it looks really pretty on the projects. So you've got the outline, you've got the die which cuts into the card, because this one doesn't have cutting edge all around. It has in few places just to hold it in place, but it just a perfect die to cut into your card. And we've got those two bunnies as well. So as you can see on this packaging, it looks really pretty and I really like that one. I think that was my favorite. And of course I love sentiments, so these are the set of sentiments. And we've got Happy Easter and God bless you, Happy Easter to the whole family. I hope it's a fun one for all of you. Have a happy Easter, Easter wishes, love, peace, love, and Easter blessings. Wishing you a happy, heartwarming Easter time. And there are two more as well. So really nice sentiments. I love sentiments and I love buying sentiments. So this one, I think I had 2 years ago, there was this Easter collection in a box from Crafters Companion. I have it somewhere up above my desk, so I have to dig it out closer to Easter time, so I can mix and match together with those. So, and we've got this create a card, a floral cross. It has two cutting dies. Let me show you. So this one, you can again, you can cut into the card and you can cut the frame as well, but because we've got that frame die as well. So let me show you maybe this one so you can see exactly how this one looks like. And I created this one. It's a very simple project and I just cut into the card blank. I created my card blank using centura pearl, and I adhere a vellum underneath that panel so you can see it has this nice effect. I kept it very simple. And of course I use the sentiment from the stamp set from this one as well, and two colors only, and some nouveau drops, just to show that it can be kept quite nice, clean and simple. I really like this one. I know it's very simple, but I wanted to show you how to create simple ones, simple projects which you can put into the envelope and just post without any extra costs. So that's this one. And then the last one is this beautiful cross, and it's called Miracle of Easter. There are four pieces in the set. So let me show you. Those are so pretty and they cut really nicely. So you've got the outside edge cutting die. You can cut into your card. And then you've got that cross with the cutting edge around it, but you can create the background as well. So so like a shadow die. I love this set and I think this one looks really pretty, and you can use it for many different occasions, not only for Easter. For example, if you do some like a Holy Communion or something like that, you can use that as well. So a really nice die set. This one, I didn't tell you the measurements of it, but I hope you can actually stop the video and check the measurements. So this one is 3.9 by 5 inches. So let me show you the products, because once I finish showing you the samples, I'm going to post them because I need to send them off to Crafters Companion so they can show it on Crafters TV, HSN, or any other channels they're going to use that collection on. So this is the one I showed you before with that cross and that cutting into your cardstock with a sentiment from the same collection. And let me show you those cute bunnies that egg-shaped cutting die, really pretty. This one I created like a full stepper card. I showed how to create it on my channel, so this one is really simple, so you very easy to follow. If you want to know or how to create it, just ask me and I will send you the link. Just comment below the video so I can do that. And I kept it nice and simple with pink and greens, and I think they work really well, those bunnies and the sentiment from that stamp set. This one is actually an easel card. I love making easel cards, and this cutting die is so pretty that I decided to actually show you that you can use that egg to create an egg shaped easel card. And the sentiment is from that stamp set, so I hope you like that one as well. I add here those bunnies on a 3D foam pad just to leave them off the page a little bit. So this is the second, and then I really couldn't resist and I had to do a shaker card. And of course green and pinks for Easter, for spring, it's really nice. And I just didn't want to use any patterned paper, so I used just cardstock in green and pink, just to show off that beautiful egg and those bunnies. So I hope you like this one. Now I will show you a few projects I did using that stamp set Joy, Easter Joy, and that beautiful dove. And we had some foliage as well, which you can stamp and color and use it with any flowers. Like in this one is a Z fold card, double Z fold card, very simple, again just to show off that stamp. And you can use your watercolors, alcohol markers, anything you want just to color them. So I think on all of them I used aqua markers from Crafters Companion, and they work really well. So on this project I actually stamped those leaves, and I fussy cut them out together with that dove, and I stamped and colored Joy on that white card. Then on this one I actually created my panel using that stamp, and my favorite, as you can see, is the one with those simple leaves. I use the other stamp under that flower, as you can see. So that's another design of that leaf, which is in that set, because we're getting two. This one is my favorite, as you can see, and that's the other one. So you can use any of those to create a beautiful background. And I just created this panel on green. I adhered the Joy on foam pads, and I created that banner and stamped Easter with that dove and some gems. Gems are actually from Crafters Companion, and these are crystal droplets. I think they were from Mermaid collection, if I'm not mistaken. So I really like this one. I think this one is really nice, and I had so much fun creating the background. The same with this one, quite simple, but if you're not going to use 3D foam pads like I did under that oval shape, you can actually send it in a standard envelope. So these two are really easy to make. And then of course every time I create something I have to do that hexagonal pop-up card, and I use this cross to create this one. So that's the shape. And if you haven't seen me creating this hexagonal pop-up card, you can find it on my channel as well, the step-by-step tutorial with all the measurements. So and that's another project, and this one is from this die set, so floral cross. And then the last one I'm going to show you, this miracle of Easter. So this one is another easel card. So you've got only two colors, as you can see, pink and purple, with those the same gems as I showed you before from those crystal droplets. I'll try to link everything below the video so you can check out what kind of products I used. So this one is the Easter card, last project with this beautiful collection. So let me know which one is your favorite. Are you going to go for the full collection, or maybe you just are thinking, should I get it or not? Hopefully I will inspire you somehow to create your own project with this beautiful collection. So thank you so much for watching. Let me know which one is your favorite project maybe, and what do you think about this collection. So thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in my next video. Bye for now.